A very good morning to all of you. Today I am going to teach mathematics of class 6. It is a new chapter, linear equations in one variable. Okay, here you are going to learn a new things. Okay, so get ready and try to understand whatever I am going to say. Okay, now first with an example I start. Suppose that you know 2 plus 3 equals 5. Okay? Or 2 into 3, that is 6. Here we have used symbol of equal to. What is that? This is the symbol of equal to. It is a symbol of equality. This equation is a symbol of equality. Okay, this is called symbol of equality, equal to. Okay, did you got it? Now, so statement of equality, here we are going to learn what is the statement of equality. When any statement when we use the symbol of equal to, that it says statement of equality. Okay, when any statement, in a statement we use the symbol of equal to symbol, that is said statement of equality. And this is the example of statement of equality. And now equation, what is the equation? Now if we say a number, x increased by a number x increased by 4 is 12. Here a number x increased by 4 is 12. That you can write that a number x increased by 4 is means equal to 12. This is the statement. Okay, so this is called statement according to the number we have written. A number x increased by 4 equal to 12. So here x I have taken. Okay, x I have taken, that is an unknown number. Okay, so equation, what is the equation? So when in equality, statement of equality, when statement of equality we use a one or more than one unknown numbers, that is called variables, is called equation. Once again, when in a statement of equality we use variables is called equation. Okay, it may be one or two or three. Okay, but we are going to learn here one variable only. So another example I take, that is a statement equation. Okay, statement of equality, this is a statement of equality because we have used the symbol of equal to. Okay, yes. And it is equation because they contain one variable. Okay, it may be two variables. Suppose that a number x increased 4 times y is 100. So how can you write? A number x increased means plus 4 times y is 100. This is the statement. Okay, and we have written in equation form. So this is also example of an equation. But what is the difference? Difference is there is only one variable have been taken, but here x and y both unknown number, both are unknown number, means both are variables. This is two variables and here one variable only. Okay, I hope you got it. Now linear equation, what is the linear equation? When statement of equality, statement of equality, I have written x plus 4 equal to 2. Okay, so what is linear equation? When an equation, okay, have been taken and the power of the variable is only 1. If the power of a variable is 1, that is called linear equation. That is x, it means power is 1. If you have taken x square plus 4 equal to 12, that is not a linear, that is linear equation, but that is not a linear equation, that is quadratic equation. That is quadratic equation. You will learn in your means for the classes, that is 7, 8, 9. But here you are going to learn a linear equation. Linear equation, the equation, okay, the statement of equality, it means equation, the equation when the power of a variable is 1. Okay, it may be suppose that y plus 12 equal to 20, that is other also here one variable and the power is 1, it means it is a linear equation. Okay, a linear equation and one variable is given, that's why it is linear equation in one variable, only y is contained. Okay, that's why it is one variable and power is 1, that's why linear equation of one variable only, that is. Okay, this type of question we have to solve by the difference method. And when you find the value of y, here we are going to solve this one. Y plus 12 equal to 20, that is y equal to, take 12 this side, minus 12, plus, change, and minus. Now this is 8, y equal to 8. It means 8 is the solution of this equation, or 8 is the root of the equation. What is it? 8 is the root of the equation. Root. It is said root of the equation because f 8 satisfies this equation. Because when you put 8, 8 plus 12, 20. 8 plus 12, 20. So, it is a root of the equation. Okay? I hope you got it. Now, we are going to solve this type of equation using trial and error method. That is, suppose that here the equation is given, this equation I have taken, this one. Suppose that y plus 12 equal to 20. Okay, or simple question I am going to take, that is, suppose that x plus 4 equal to 6. X plus 4 equal to 6. Then how can you solve? How can you solve this equation? It means how can you find the value of x? So in trial and error method, first you have to write the variable. What is the variable given? X. Take x. And this part, the left of the symbol of equality, that is called left hand side. This is left. So left hand side L S S and the right side from the equal, that is R S S. Right hand side. Okay. So here write down. Make three column L S S and R H S. Okay. Now you have to take the value of x. First start from 1. When you put in LHS, that 1 plus 4. 1 plus 4, 5. And but RHS is 6. That is not equal. LHS and RHS is not equal. So you have to put some other value. That now 2. Put 2 plus 4, that is 6. And RHS is also 6. Both. Now, both are equal. That's why the value of x, now that is RHS equal to LHS. That's why x equal to 2 became the root of the equation. Solution of the equation. Okay. In trial and error method, you have to put the value first. Put 1, then 2, 3, 4, 5. Till when it becomes RHS equal to LHS, on that situation you should over it, and at that time you have to write x equal to, if the value which satisfy LHS equal to RHS, that is the root of the equation. Okay, this way you can solve the given examples in your book given. There are many examples given, so you can solve that one. Okay, so in next video we are going to solve the exercises. Till then, have a good day. Bye.